So this patient is deciding between SBRT and IMRT, which are two different types of radiation, and they want to know, is there really a major difference in the side effects that they can expect between the two?
Typically, with well-performed radiation, which depends on the quality of the center and the quality of the doctors giving the treatment, the side effects should be very similar. One side effect of modern radiation is having to go in for treatments and when you could use your time doing other things. And IMRT takes anywhere from 5 to 9 weeks, whereas SBRT only takes about a week and a half. So the side effects of SBRT are certainly less in that you don't have to go in for so many visits.
Have you seen better results with IMRT versus SBRT? I know there's a lot of different studies, but you know, if it's just a man who needs radiation in a simple spot, is that something that you would suggest one or another?
No, I don't think there's any difference. I think there is a difference between different centers and the quality of treatment that they, and the accuracy of the treatment that's delivered. But I don't think there's a difference between SBRT and IMRT if you have equally good doctors doing the treatment.
Our next question is regarding seed implants. This person is deciding on whether to get seed implants or not, and they're wondering if there's ever a chance that a seed implant can cause an infection.
Well, seeds are put into the prostate with needles, and anytime you break the skin with any type of injection or inserting a seed, there is a risk of infection. I can't recall a case that I've ever seen where someone got an infection from a seed implant. It's theoretically a concern, but practically speaking, I don't think there's much concern at all about infection. Concerns with seed implants and all types of radiation are the possibility of developing erectile dysfunction. And the other possibility that we have to face with any type of radiation is irritation of the urethra, the passage of the urine through from the bladder down through the prostate and out the penis, that the wall of the urethra can get irritated with radiation. And in a small percentage of people, they can have long-term discomfort, frequency, urgency from seed implant radiation or, for that matter, any type of radiation.
And have you seen that happen often? What percentage of patients would you say that get seed implants need to be concerned about that issue?
It's very uncommon. We try and be very selective in the doctors we utilize for doing seed implants. It is a skill, just like surgery is a skill and radiation is a skill. Long-term damage to the urethra from seed implant radiation or standard radiation in men that are being treated at top-level centers is certainly less than 5%, maybe as low as 1 to 2%.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.